Welcome to our channel Sparkles College, and this is Sadaf Meher. Today we'll be discussing about boundaryless organizations. Now, boundaryless organizations are the organizations which are not constrained by the chain of commands and formal departments like other organizational structures which we have studied before, functional, divisional. It adopts flexible structure approach and the understructure organizations where the main focus is on flexibility. There are different types of boundaryless organizations such as hollow organizations, modular organizations and virtual organizations. We'll look into the details of each one of them in our next slides. Hollow organizations activities are broken down into core and non-core activities. Core activities are the ones which are strategically important to an organization and are kept in-house, while non-core activities are outsourced to external organizations. For example, in an accountancy training organization, payroll, which is a non-core activity, can be outsourced to external third organization specializing in payroll processing. The core activities such as training students can be kept in-house. Modular organizations refer to boundaryless manufacturing companies where manufacturing process is split into modules or components. Company makes some of components and outsources other components to external suppliers. In extreme cases, all of components can be outsourced and company will only assemble them to create final product. This structure is mostly adopted in automotive companies and cell phone manufacturing companies. Another type of boundaryless organization is virtual organization, where organization simply works as network of contracts, outsources many or all of its functions to the third parties. Small central staff will coordinate with third parties and ensure that customers' needs are being met. For example, internet retailers such as Amazon, where products are bought in from manufacturers. Sales are delivered to customers by third-party couriers, and even the websites are maintained and hosted by external IT companies. That's all for today's lecture. Kindly like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.